by looking at neither audience?
No.
Yeah. Don't look at the camera.
Okay.
Stare at someone in the eyes.
Okay. Hello, my name is Grace Winfrey, and I'm here to talk to you about the topic of ocean acidification and how it affects us, our planet, our oceans, and our coral reefs. And the reason I'm interested in this topic is because I actually grew up in Florida, so I was in the water a lot, I was in the ocean a lot, and I could actually see the effects of what this was having on coral reefs. As you can see in this photograph, coral reefs are beautiful ecosystems that are vital to the success of many fish and in turn humans. There's a lot of interesting facts about coral reefs. They house tens of thousands of different kinds of marine species. They're created of thousands of identical polyps that in turn are created by calcium carbonate exoskeletons. Something that can negatively affect coral reefs is my topic, which is ocean acidification, which is when the water pH in the water decreases because of carbon dioxide that's being released in the air and absorbed into the water. And carbon dioxide is unfortunately released into the water very quickly, and it's created faster than it's absorbed. I have a quote here from NOAA that says, coral reef plants and animals are sources of new medicines being developed to treat cancer, arthritis, human bacterial infections, Alzheimer's disease, heart disease, viruses, and other diseases. So cancer is something that affects a lot of people, and there's actually candy cures that are found in coral reefs. There are also a lot of other reasons that coral reefs are really important, one of them being it's actually important storm shielding for protection around islands during storms. There's a lot of fish that live in coral reefs that are used in fisheries, and we eat them. And it also creates a lot of money and profit for things like recreation and tourism, because when people go to take pictures, snorkel, lobster, etc., they're making money for local businesses where they stay and where they eat. So you may be aware that coral reefs are decreasing in size from things you've heard in the news and the media, but you probably don't know what you can do about it, and I'm going to tell you along with this list that I found. So one thing you can do is conserving water, because then there's, believe it or not, there's less runoff. So if you're not using as much water, there's not as much pollutants getting washed into the coral reefs. If you help reduce fossil fuel emissions by doing things like walking, biking, or riding the bus, as opposed to driving your car, then, or even carpooling, so you can use a car with someone else, then you're not using as much and you're reducing fossil fuel emissions. And then something you can do when you're in an area where there's coral reefs that might be more rare, but is actually supporting reef-friendly businesses, so you can ask them what they're doing to help the reef and support them over a different business. Unfortunately, a total of 10% of the world's coral reefs have been destroyed completely by ocean acidification. So as you can see, that is that you start with some healthy coral, and then when it gets bleached, it dies and it looks dead-looking. And bleaching's main cause is ocean acidification, and it actually has become much more severe since 1998. So there's a really interesting website I found while I was researching this from a man named David Lichtwager, who has a quote that says, there's more life in one cubic foot than anyone can look at in a month. So the project he's been working on is that he has a cube made out of piping, a foot by a foot by a foot, and he travels with it and carries it all around the world, different locations, and then like in a rainforest or a desert, and he'll put it, or a creek or anywhere like that, and he'll put it in there, and then he'll record how many organisms he found in there. And this is actually a really interesting project, because even a class like ours could do it, because you just need to take the cube and put it in a location like this and then write down everything, which helps the scientific community, because there's like a website where they collect it. And what I found interesting about this is that the amount of organisms he found in coral reefs rivals even that of like tropical rainforests, which are known for having a lot of different organisms. And another thing that this shows that's important about reefs is there's so many organisms that represent like billions of years of evolution, so it's showing what's been changing. This is a picture from an oil spill, and this is one of the gas workers' helmets in the water. And I was using this slide because there's some controversy over the ocean, whether or not the ocean is really getting more acidic, because some people claim that human carbon dioxide is only like a tiny percentage of carbon dioxide emissions. But in reality, although nature is adding more carbon dioxide, it's also removing carbon dioxide as a part of its natural process, so it keeps a balance, but humans are adding the extra carbon dioxide. most on the Earth, and that's a change of 0.06 to 0.08, so the pH is changing, and this is caused by carbon dioxide. So this is another diagram, and it's showing that carbon dioxide is really the biggest percentage of fossil fuels that are being released. And since over 70% of the carbon dioxide emissions are from within very city limits, the people who are working on this problem are people like mayors, who are supported by local people like us, and they're working on a lot of different programs to reduce greenhouse gas emissions from cities and factories. So, together, we can help decrease ocean acidification and save the coral reefs and the planet that we have left. And you can make a difference. The people in the picture are signing petitions. And what you can do is you can spread awareness and write to your local and national politicians, because taking the time out of your day to write a letter to someone about an issue that you care about is going to make them realize that people care about the issue. But what is actually even better than writing a letter is writing a letter and then having a petition signed, because then it shows that not only you care about the issue, but you're trying to get everyone else to care about the issue and you want to see it fixed. So these are some local politicians that were working on the oil spill, which I thought was good because it was showing how people can help with issues like these. And the brochure that I created, which I don't have with me, which is black and white, but I have one printed up, is spreading awareness of the issue so people can decide if it's an issue that they care about. And my last slide was the beach thingy slide. And I just want to say thank you so much for listening, and I hope that you will consider attempting to help save the coral reefs.